singing a song. Saddles and boots, jogging along.
Jogging along.
Each day with a thrill.
Letters of skill.
Surely we know we must fulfill. We're mountain men. The odds may be 1 to 10. We'll follow the trail. We never will fail to capture. Dangerous roads, for everyone knows we say. Get a man, despite any plan, he'll have to win. Our will won't bend, and honor we must defend. Our job may be tough, we'll call any bluff, we'll stick to the very end. Proud of the coat that we wear, but it's eager to share the work mountain men.
All right. Hi, Jones. Hello, Johnny. I'm certainly glad to escort the gold shipment today. The old man is crabbier than ever.
Yeah, the boss is as crabby as an old she-bear trying to catch a tsetse fly in the woods. Yeah, in the woods where the squirrels in the tree think he's nuts.
Get going on those gold boxes. Quit talking about trees.
Yeah, boss. Everything comes in trees. Everything.
Take off your hat. Oh, not you. You're not going.
But, Mr. Hatch, I always go.
Not today. I need that report you're working on at once. Besides, we're insured. Oh, get out of the way.
Hi, Ma.
Hello, son. Going to Fullerton?
Yep, and I'm going to buy out the town for you. What do you want?
Got a load of gold in the car.
Well, if it isn't asking too much, I wish you'd buy me a dime's worth of my favorite gumdrops.
Sure thing.
I'm glad I caught you before you left, Hill. Maxwell wants you to deliver an important package for him.
But that's against the rules. The car's in the hire of the bank now. If I stop by the yard, we may lose the contract.
Maybe you're right, but Maxwell owns his truck and them's his orders. You got a better job lined up?
I guess you know why I can't quit Maxwell. For a while, anyway. So long, Jones.
Goodbye, Hale.
Where's Maxwell?
Imagine my embarrassment now if I can't find the package.
What's so important about it?
It's for a young lady I'm very fond of. I promised it for her today. Oh, just a minute, George.
The air should pop just before he goes down Devil's Gorge.
There won't be enough pressure left in the brake system to stop a kitty car.
I'd like to see his face when he tries to get out through the automatic door. It won't open when the car's moving.
Your work's been okay, so I'm raising your salary $10 a week. It'll make it a lot easier for you to pay off that money you owe me.
Thanks. I'm glad you don't feel bad about my not wanting to drive those changed over trucks of yours.
Forget it.
The gold locked up in the shop.
Good. Now get this. Follow him in the other armored car. After he crashes, drive through cold water and double back tonight. It'll look as though he went through headed for the border.
Smart guy. He wouldn't play ball with us on the hot cars.
And I just raised his salary. It's like feeding a prisoner turkey dinner just before the hanging.
We're driving the cold water.
Renfrew is coming now.
I'll bet we covered that last 10 miles and nothing flat. Inspector must want us for an important case, huh?
Hey, what's the matter? What have we, what has Renfrew done now?
You still want to see Renfrew, sir?
No.
Dismissal from the service is a serious thing to us men, sir. Won't you please consider his past excellent record?
All right. Send the floundering fool in.
Genevieve just got back from school. She's giving Renfrew the razzmatazz.
Swell. Now there'll be some life around here.
Let's get a load of it.
Sergeant Renfrew reporting, sir.
Was Sergeant Renfrew. Mr. Renfrew now.
Well, I'm sorry, sir, if I did anything against regulations.
Regulations fiddlesticks. I'm throwing out those old-fashioned rules with the rest of you dumb-witted cops. From now on, I'm going to run a modern, scientific detective bureau. And I'll eradicate crime in this district by detecting the man higher up, not the henchman.
Up to your old tricks again, eh, Brad? You may have gone to college, but I can still spank you.
You do things that drive me wild, and you're dynamite to me. You cause me such trouble, I must put you cross my knee. Spare the rod and spoil the child, it's an adage old but true. And to spank you, it would hurt me more than you.
Oh, why, hello, Dad. I was just giving Renfrew some jiu-jitsu lessons. Modern science versus dumb brute strength.
Our little tomboy is certainly a big girl now, isn't she?
I'll say she is.
Do you remember her promising us she'd learn how to make peach melba?
And green apple pie? Yes, sir.
Well, we're not going to get them. She studied criminology instead of cooking.
No peach melba? No green apple pie?
No, the kitchen is no place for me. I'm going to help Dad create a new psychological bureau for crime detection.
Well, the good die young. Come on, we'll finish his trip through Coldwater to the border road.
And I don't like to say this, but Jones told me he'll ask his mother what she wanted from Fullerton. Said he had a load of gold in the truck. He's probably in the States by now.
That only shows that he'll expect it to return, doesn't it, Mr. Hatch?
You see, my daughter's been studying criminal psychology. Sergeant Renfrew will look into the case immediately.
Well, all right.
Well, my dear, what did your spotlight disclose?
He's the physical mechanical type. Did you notice his extra large thumbs when he fixed that screw on the box?
I guess he noticed there was a screw loose around here, too.
Well, the first place I look for that missing gold is in Hatch's own vault.
Well, that's startling. Go on. I'm interested in how a modern detective would solve a crime, sitting in an office.
Hatch is mechanical, so we worked out a method of switching the gold boxes, then sent a fake shipment. He was too sure the driver had escaped to the States.
Why, Thomas Hatch is one of our most respected citizens.
It's just why he could get away with it. Many big racketeers are financed by bankers. Why, according to my criminology professor, who made quite a jail study.
Did your professor say this before or after he got out of jail?
Hatch is what Lombroso might call a Neanderthal throwback. They always work that way. And furthermore, Father, I'm not solving this crime by sitting in your office.
Now, just a minute, my dear. Sergeant Renfrew is in charge of the case, and if he needs your assistance, I'm quite sure he'll ask for it.
Oh, that's all right. Glad to have her help. But I'd much rather settle for some green apple pie with lots of nice, flaky crust.
You got it.
Real green apple pie?
No, the crust.
This is my favorite picture of George. It was taken when he graduated from high school. His father and I were so proud of him.
Lots of character. I wish I had known him.
You'd like him, too. He's been rather quiet lately. Troubled. Didn't seem to want to talk about it. I'm so worried.
We'll do our best to find him. A fellow wouldn't willingly stay away from a mother like you and apple pie like this.
I wanted to go along as usual, but old man Hatch said he needed the report. I bet he hasn't looked at it yet.
After the gold was loaded, did he head straight for Fullerton?
Come to think of it, he made a turn. Must have gone back to the truck yard to get someone to go along.
Hello, Maxwell.
Hello, Sergeant. Hear about our little trouble?
Yes.
You know, it's the first time there's been a holdup or robbery on one of my trucks. It really don't do my business any good.
Who was in the armored car?
George Hill. The bank told me they didn't send an escort as they usually do. I hate to say this, but being alone, the temptation might have been too much for poor George. Maxwell Trucking Company. Yeah, just a minute. It's for you, Sergeant.
Yes, Kelly.
George Hill returned to the truck yard after he picked up the gold at the bank.
Okay, better check the Fullerton Road. Very few people travel it, but perhaps you can learn something.
Right.
You didn't tell me the driver returned here after leaving the bank. That makes you the last person that saw Hill.
Well, you see, Sergeant, it was a truly irregular kill to deliver a box of candy to a girlfriend in Fullerton. No harm in a little sentiment, is there?
No, I don't suppose so. But hereafter, when you have any doubts about valuable shipments, call us. The Mounted will be glad to furnish you with a guard.
Thank you very much. I'll remember that.
Quite a place you've got here. Mind if I look around?
Not at all. I'll go with you.
Yellow Stripe, quick, get those license plates out of sight.
This room is kept locked. One of the boys is working on an invention, a new butane carburetor.
An interesting place, Maxwell. I'll be back again, soon.
He's a smart guy, and I never like smart guys.
I recognize Mr. Hatch, but which one of those two is me? My pictures never did flatter me. But I thought I shaved this morning. Where's your father?
He'll be back pretty soon. I'm doing this chart on the physical characteristics of criminals for him.
And what does that mean in the Queen's English?
An animal built like a gorilla behaves like one, since the behavior of an animal or man depends upon his physical makeup. His body, therefore, gives us a clue to his mental and emotional responses. In other words, his body indicates how he will act. Now, scientific prison study shows us that short, thin men steal. Tall, thin men kill and rob. Tall, heavy men murder and forge.
What about midgets?
Hey, listen, Renfrew, this is important.
Please pardon the vulgar interruption, my dear professor.
I just got back from Coldwater and did some clever detective work, even if I do say so myself. I traced the armored car to the border road. It looks bad for George Hill.
Did anyone recognize Hill?
No, but a restaurant man and a gasoline station attendant, where Hill usually trades, distinctly saw the armored car go by about...
Never mind the time. Why didn't you continue to trace the car?
Well, there wouldn't be any use. Hill and his gang would transfer the gold to an airplane and be in the States long ago.
Yes, and then they'd transfer the armored car to a flock of goats and eat up the evidence.
You're both wasting time. Hill is only a stooge for Hatch. Why didn't Hatch send his honest clerk Jones to escort the gold shipment this time? Look here. The pronounced cheekbones, membranous lips, upper thin, lower thick, median, and mongoloid eye form.
Say, you've got something there.
Plus his extra large thumbs gives us the exact characteristics of the clever mechanical forger and killer.
So you're really convinced that Hatch deliberately planned the disappearance of the armored car?
Of course. If Hill had been driving, Kelly's gas attendant and restaurant man would have recognized him, wouldn't they? The man who drove didn't want to be recognized.
Pure thing, darling.
Yes, well, I'll prove to you he's the man who thought he planned the perfect crime. The missing gold is still in his own vault. I'm going calling tonight.
Look, if you're wrong, will you give up this detective business and get back in the kitchen and make me some,
Solve the crime?
I'll turn in my chevrons and I'll cook for you.
Okay, Oscar the Waldorf. It's a bet.
Telegram.
You two pick the oddest places for your necking.
You spoiled everything by following me.
If keeping you out of jail from 10 years to life is spoiling everything.
I tell you, the gold boxes are inside the vault. You're afraid to let me prove it to you.
Now, wait a minute. The things they teach young people nowadays in college. I want you to promise me never to play.
That's cat oil for the drill, but you can have it if you want it.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells.
Well, you certainly gave him a sleigh ride. Come on, Jenny Valentine.
I didn't like the way that yellow stripe was snooping around here, boss. I think we ought to ship this gold across the border right away.
No, they'll be searching for George Hill in the States. This is the safest place till the excitement blows over. Right under their noses.
Business, boss. Joe heard horses down the road, and I just saw somebody moving along the fence.
Huh. My smart friend Renfrew really meant it when he said soon.
We'll give him a surprise party.
Right, and we won't be blamed for shooting prowlers on our own property.
But, boss, if we're investigated and they find that gold here, you know...
What have we got trucks for? I know what to do with bodies. Come on with me.
Mighty nice of them to pick up and leave. We could have waited there all night.
Yes, but it might be the old spider on the fly business. Open. More hospitality. Seems to me we'd better hit and run.
My skeleton key will show just what skeletons are in this closet.
I had a hunch we'd falling for that spider gag. Get the light.
All right, you prowlers, whoever you are, come on out with your hands high. We won't shoot. We'll just turn you over to police. Come on out!
All set? Ready.
How's the jiu-jitsu expert?
In the pink, my boy.
Do you want to see Renfrew, sir?
Not now. Oh, well, send him in.
That you, Renfrew? Sit down a minute. I want to tell you something.
Rod and spoil the child is an adage old but true. While you're in the closet, it hurts me more than you. You do things that drive me wild and you're naughty as can be. Someday I'm gonna take you cross my knee. Like a kid of six, you're full of tricks. You should be put to bed. Little baby kin to your chagrin, I'll put pepper on your tongue instead. You would not be locked in there if you did the things you should. You'll stay in the closet till you promise to be good.
Well, enough this door, I'd better open it in a hurry.
The first thing a detective should learn, Renfrew, is not to lock up the wrong person.
Now, see here, Genevieve, really, you're getting too old for tricks like this.
But, Father,
well, you see, it really was my fault. We'll not discuss it anymore. Just don't do it again. Well, this morning, the bank reported a burglary. The criminals had started to blow up the bank safe.
But they departed hurriedly, leaving the watchman.
Well, that's correct. But how did you know?
Well, you said they started. Otherwise, you would have said they burgled the bank of a certain amount of money.
Apparently, something frightened them away.
Oh, no, only one of them was frightened. The other was very smart and could have done the job easily.
And I suppose your criminal studies will tell you exactly what followed?
Oh, no, I don't have to look in books. You see, the one that was frightened was very clumsy and had a funny face, was about Renfrew's size and intelligence.
Well, I'll admit, I don't understand this modern deduction. What do you think of it, Renfrew?
Well, I'm afraid she's right, sir.
There must be an organized gang operating here. You'd better speed up your investigation, Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, and another report came in this morning from the Maxwell Trucking Company.
Some prowlers.
That would be the same frightened burglar. Afraid to blow a safe, he stooped to the lowest criminal category, the prowl.
You still think she's right, Sergeant?
Well, I'm afraid she's still right, sir.
For 30 years, I've had the finest record in the whole force. And now modern scientific methods come in and... I'm a has-been.
Yes, sir. I mean, no, sir. I'm not going to tattle on your bank robbery, but you've got to tell him the truth yourself. And furthermore, I'm not a funny face.
You are, too. Now tell him when I land Hatch in the booby hatch and you're in the kitchen dishing up the hash.
Hatch?
No, I said hash.
I remembered your kind offer, Sergeant. It's mighty nice of you to ask for today's gold shipment.
Now you're really doing me a favor.
Because it might help you locate the missing armored truck?
Yes.
Well, I hope you find it.
I'll tell the boys to get the truck ready.
It worked. Better allow more time on the acid before he hits Devil's Gorge. He's got to stop by at the bank first.
They'll have you fixed up in a minute, Sergeant.
Well, haven't you forgotten one thing? Something very important.
What?
The sentimental side. A box of candy for the young lady in Fullerton.
Oh, I wouldn't trust a Don Juan like you anywhere near a girl of mine.
I'd never see her again. There you are, Sergeant. I certainly did forget something important, wise guy. I forgot to ask what kind of flowers you like.
Are you sure those gold boxes haven't been taken from the vault?
Yeah, I'm sure, but...
Are you sure you're sure?
Sure, I'm sure, but...
Quit sputtering like a motorboat. Look, about the boxes, are you sure?
No, but Mr. Hatch has got to ship them out pretty soon.
I hear the bank was held up.
Yeah, there were 10 gangsters, 4 little ones and 6 big ones, and 1 fat one. And here I am, all by myself, standing over the... I'm here. And I got a hold of one of these gangsters. I was so mad. I grabbed him on the phone. I started. Yes?
The armored truck should be there by now. Sergeant Renfrew is driving, so you can be sure the gold will be delivered this time.
All right. Jones?
Yes, sir.
Jones, get the Fullerton gold shipment ready right away.
Yes, sir. Do I go along?
No. A mounted police sergeant is driving. He can handle it alone.
My, Johnny, and you didn't even get scratched.
Do you see this jaw?
Uh-huh.
Well, I can take it.
Like this? Well, if it isn't Renfrew, are you by any chance going to Fullerton?
Why, my female Charlie Chan?
Well, you see, I have some very important shopping to do in Fullerton, and I'd just love to go with you.
Well, I'd just love to have you go, but I'm so sorry. You see, I've got to take Kelly. He's got some important investigating to do.
Sign this, please.
Come on, Kelly. We're going for a joyride.
Oh, you came to the right man.
I need an escort.
Oh, am I an escort? What's the young lady's name?
Goldilocks. She's an armored truck. Make it snappy. I'll be outside.
Come in.
Hurry up, Kelly. You're as slow as an old woman.
Get to go, Kelly.
I almost broke down and took Genevieve. Oh, there's a lovely girl. My, how beautiful she'd look in the kitchen with a flowered gingham apron baking me a delicious apple pie. Too bad she's cracked about this criminology business. I've seen some dumb correspondence school detectives in my day, but she had to go to college to get all dumbed up.
I hope he crashes in shallow water.
That'll make it easy to get two more boxes of gold.
Yeah, and I don't mind being out of the trucking business until those new armored cars arrive.
Hey, boss, how'd you get that yellow stripe to drive?
Well, the payoff is he asked for it. When he hits that water, the fish are going to say, "Here comes sucker Renfrew."
Tied you up?
An Indian, 6 feet tall, war paint and everything, hit me over the head with a Tommy Hawk.
Well, you're not drunk, and you couldn't have tied yourself up. It couldn't be that you've been working too hard, Kelly.
Oh, no, sir. I mean...
Well, hurry into a uniform. Catch up with Renfrew.
Yes, sir. Indian, 7 feet tall.
If she can make poached eggs on toast and bake the pie I like the most, that's the kind of girl for me. Though she may not be very smart, if she can make peach melba tart, that's the kind of girl for me. Now Cleopatra knew her onions, so they say in books. I want a girl who knows her onions only when she cooks. She doesn't know her P's and Q's, but as long as she can make beef stews, that's the kind of girl for me. Now Venus had so many charms, but I want someone who has arms. That's the kind of girl for me. And Miss DuBarry knew her stuff, but nowadays not quite enough. That's the kind of girl for me. Now Adam, he was tempted by the apple of his eye, and I too could be tempted, but with real green apple pie. Salome made John lose his head, but I would lose my heart instead to the kind of girl for me.
Those your sentiments, Kelly? Kelly, we're coming into Devil's Gorge. I hope you like roller coasting.
Not too close, Gimpy. We'll be there in plenty of time.
Thank you.
won't open as long as the car is moving.
This is all my fault, this whole detective business. I wanted to please Daddy. He always wanted a boy, so I studied criminology to try to help him, and now I've messed things up for you.
Just hang on. You'll be okay.
I promise I'll never try to play detective again as long as I live.
You think he recognized us?
Nah, he was streaking too fast.
Look out! We're going to crash! Break it up, Neckers. At it again. You know, it beats me the places you two pick for your lovemaking. But tell me, do you have to lock yourselves in an armored car?
Indians, tommyhawks.
Hey, was Maxwell supposed to follow you in his car?
No, why?
Well, I saw him and some of his men up at the top of the gorge.
And I may be right. He'll probably pick up this car after we leave. Put the gold boxes in the roadster. We're taking them on to Fullerton.
Right.
Why, if it isn't Miss Moto. Say, I thought you were going to give up playing detective.
Well, that was at least 5 minutes ago.
Hey, Kelly, hurry up. I'm hungry.
For your own cooking, dear.
Did you find George Hill?
Yes, poor fella. He didn't have a chance.
I wonder how it happened.
Well, I found a hole in the air brake tubing.
Well, that's just what happened to the truck you drove. What caused the hole?
Well, an acid burn. Did anyone see you?
Nah. And if they did, our disguise is perfect. Hey, I'll bet Betty's a beaut.
I don't think she exists except in Maxwell's imagination. Tear off his handwriting and stick it in your pocket.
Well, anyway, the gold's real.
You won't find enough gold in those boxes to make your wedding ring. If you can ever find a girl who won't give you the air.
Listen, Renfrew, it's a good thing that new diving suit of yours doesn't need an air pump. If it did, I'd sure forget to give you the air.
I just saw the yellow stripes diving for the armored car.
Oh, so Renfrew's looking for the wreck. I'm going to tie a tin can to that guy.
Watch where you're going. You'll scare the fish.
Let him have it full speed. Kelly, and Renfrew won't last long down there without Kelly pumping him air. I'm not taking any chances. We're traveling. Come on, let's go.
Mr. Hatch.
Yes?
The Ladies Friday Morning Club that meets every Thursday afternoon would like to have you address them today on how to make their checkbook come out even.
No woman ever balances a checkbook. Can't you make it next week? You see...
But Mr. Hatch, they meet this week.
You'll have to excuse me now.
Oh, I know, but Mr. Hatch, look, I promise that...
I'll be glad to explain to the ladies why they still have checks in their book with no balance in the bank next week.
But Mr. Hatch, what am I going to do? They'll think...
I'm sorry to leave you and the ladies so unbalanced. But in just a half hour, the river steamer leaves with me on it.
Well, aloha, and bon voyage, and have a nice time.
Nothing like getting away in a traveling fortress. I hope you fixed the brakes.
They're perfect. I'm driving this time.
I forgot some papers in the office. I'll be back in a minute.
Can't figure out why they haven't opened fire on us. There'll be some trickery pretty quick. We're coming to their favorite spot, Devil's Gorge.
I'm afraid you boys are out of your class with Lefty and Gimpy. They're postgraduates of Alcatraz.
Slow down some more, Gimpy. After I pepper them, stop sudden and let them get ahead of us.
Quit talking and let them have it.
Look out, Kelly, here comes the fireworks.
Our only chance is to get their tires.
your 10 soldiers know that truck is bulletproof, you may have a lot of nerve. I think you're just plain dumb.
You may be right, Maxwell. I'm a half-wit and Kelly's studying to be an idiot.
Look, who said those Mounties are dumb? I can't shoot them red apples away from the boss, because my name ain't William Tell.
I got it. When we come to a wide spot in the road, I'll turn and jam them.
Sitting up here between us ought to make you feel awfully smart.
You'd better get the tire now. They'll leave us cold on the straightaway.
Put acid on their air brake hose, Maxwell.
Well, I'm glad to see that you're going domestic at last, my dear. But remember, make the peach melba for me first.
Well, you'll have to ask Renfrew about that. He lost his bet. The apron's for him.
Oh. Yes?
They're here, sir.
All right, send them in. Renfrew is coming in with your mastermind, my dear.
That girl deliberately locked me in malt. Missed my boat.
Congratulations, Sergeant. I'm glad you realized I was right and brought in this magnum pituitary type. And incidentally, the most dangerous to society.
What's she talking about?
I'll explain, sir. Mr. Hatch came in by himself to prefer charges against you. When he learns why you locked him up, I'm sure he'll drop them.
Oh, come, come. What is it? What is it?
Well, you see, sir, we wanted the bank robbers to believe that we thought you were guilty, so they would fall in our trap. Thanks to you, we got them all. Sherlock, my mastermind. We had you brought in to ask you one more question, Maxwell. One of the force's brilliant criminologists believes you're in the employ of Mr. Hatch.
Who, me? Say, in my racket, I'm tops. Ain't nobody giving me no orders, leastwise no pickle puss like this guy.
I'm going to see you get the full penalty of the law, Maxwell. That will give you something to laugh about for years to come. Say, while I was locked up, I found some valuable securities I'd forgot all about. So I'm going to write you a check to add to the insurance reward.
Well, thanks. I accept. George Hill's mother can use the money.
Well, all right. Good day.
And I think I'm going to ask Mrs. Hill to give you some cooking lessons.
You win, darling. I promise I'll never try to play detective again as long as I live.
Hello.
You say a foreign espionage agent has been flown into our territory? Get me descriptions of the man and the pilot.
Oh, you won't need the descriptions, Dad. The pilot would be an ex-flyer from the last war, about 45 years old, and
Excuse me, Inspector. The mastermind is turning on the heat in the kitchen oven. They're at it again.